Have you been writing all your life, or when did you decide that you were a writer?
Well, I think I decided, like, when I was 10, I had a diary, and I would write little stories, and I always wanted to write a book because my friends always said I was really good at writing fiction, and I never really got serious about it until Hubpages, because I used to be a teacher. I hated that, but something about Hubpages gave me a chance to start writing and get into it, so that's how I kind of got back into it, and now, you know, I'm working on my novel, and through Hubpages, I think, you know, I learned a lot that I like writing.
Well, I don't know what to ask about first, your Hubpages experience maybe, and then we'll get into your novel. So, you were on Hubpages longer than I was. You were one of the veterans when I joined. How did you find Hubpages?
Okay, it's so funny, but I found them on, I think, Craigslist. They were advertising something about jobs for writing, and I just really liked the site, and I made a couple hubs, and it was really nice and friendly in the beginning. It's not bad now, it's still good, it just got bigger, and I liked it when it was smaller, because I'm more into smaller things, and more supportive back then, like in 2008, I really liked it back then. It's just a little big now, I don't have a problem with it, that's one thing I like about your site, that it's kind of small. That's what I like.
Yeah, I like small homey things. I even like, you know, universities that are smaller and departments that are smaller because you get to know everybody. So same thing, I think, you know, when you've got a smaller site. So your novel is set in Hawaii, is that right?
It is in California and Hawaii. Most of it takes place in Hawaii. The first part's in California. It's about this woman, based on my experience. She was a teacher. She hated it. And she goes to Hawaii on vacation, and she loves Hawaii. And she ends up, you know, coming back to California, but a few years later, she decides to go back to Hawaii. So the duration, the rest of the novel takes place in Hawaii. It's kind of like a modern romance novel, but not like Harlequin. Like, there's modern takes on things. So I'm on page 200, and I'm still working and seeing where it evolved from there, you know. So it's exciting.
Okay, tell me a little bit about hating teaching, because you don't hear that a lot, but, you know, I feel a lot of sympathy. So tell me a little bit.
Well, it's not that I hate it. I mean, I do sub occasionally, but what I didn't like, had bad experiences. Like, I had a kid threw a ball on my head and just, like, crazy stuff and, like, parents that would... Just, like, I taught in places that were really isolated, and just, it wasn't a good community, so it's not that I hate teaching, I just don't want to do it after those experiences. When you had a parent tell you that they might kill you because their son was acting up in class, and you let him know about it, that's kind of scary, you know? It scared me a little bit, so I just wanted space away from it, and that's why I left teaching. It just, I feel better out of it, and... You know, working at a library is a little bit more my personality because I never liked taking charge, and that was one problem I had. My classroom management wasn't always the best. I'd have kids kind of taking advantage of me. So it's better for me to be a writer or work at a library, something more low-key for my personality. So that's, and, you know, honestly, I didn't want to be a teacher. My grandpa was a teacher, and he told me I should go into it, and that's how I got into that vocation in the beginning. So that's why I'm not in it anymore.
Okay. Yeah, so it's best to make your own decisions about your life. So tell me about the romantic interest in the story.
In the story, it's not like I set out to write a romance novel in the beginning. It's kind of a parody of romance novels because I hate how they always try to sell, like, this romantic idea. So... He's more of a modern person. He's not perfect, but he's a businessman. He owns a business. His parents wanted him to be a lawyer, which is based on what some people I know. And basically, it's just a story about people finding themselves, figuring out what they want to do. And he is romantic towards the end, but he doesn't really discover that until he grows up. It's kind of like a critique of modern day Western life, like in the Western states. Like, things I've gone through. And, you know, just a critique of things that I've experienced. Mostly, so I'm still working on it. I'm not done yet. We'll see how it goes. But, you know, it's going good.
I look forward to hearing more about it. Maybe you can post some excerpts, even.
I might. I'm just leery to do that after I've had things copied. I might do that. I keep having things copied. You know, and it's kind of scary.
That's not good.
I've had a lot of it. Like, and it is very irritating as a writer to have to do those DMCA. I hate that so much. You know, but you have to do what you have to do to protect your writing. It's your intellectual property. You can't let it be stolen.
Right. Yeah. What was that? Was that a site in Turkey or Russia that had you copied?
Russia at first, but then I did another search, and the domain is registered in the Netherlands. So it's really weird. I don't know. Like, it was in Russian at first, but then I went and did another search, and the site is actually registered in the Netherlands. I think it might be a Turkish domain name that they purchased, but the people live in the Netherlands. It's just a very odd, peculiar site because it has a weird name to it. It's not even like a name for searching.
Yeah, I tried to look that up to see if it was a word in some language, and apparently not.
No, it's just really weird. And my experience, I've had like a couple of Chinese boys that stole my content, and then they would insert links to shoe ads. Like, I've had some really weird things, like jewelry hubs or websites, like where I write an article about how to make jewelry, and they'll steal things and they'll put in shoe links. And I'm just like, this is interesting. It doesn't make any sense, like the way that they choose to do it. Like, you would think that they would at least take content and make it sensical, but to me it makes no sense. I can't explain it. It's just really weird.
Well, yeah, that's marketing, because the fact of the matter is I don't think that necessarily the best written material, you know, and the best arranged material is the material that ends up, you know, getting the most clicks. So I don't really know what they're thinking, or does that make any sense?
No, I know what you're saying, because I know there's some people that are really good at marketing. I don't think that they are. I think they're just taking anything from any site and putting it on their site in hopes that somebody's going to buy something from Amazon. Because I noticed they have links to Amazon on their website.
Uh-huh.
And they're copying different things. So it's peculiar, but I've seen a lot of that. Some people actually left Hubpages because they were tired of people taking their content off the site.
Yeah. Right. Well, what do you think about the Panda update? Or did that make any dent in your situation?
It did a little bit for Hubpages, to be honest with you. I did lose a lot of traffic. My other sites gathered more traffic. I started writing for eHow more again because I was making payout every month with AdSense, and then it diminished to where I wasn't making it every month anymore. And that was a little bit of extra income, and I can actually make a little bit more with eHow if I write for them monthly. Yeah, so yeah, I did make a dent, and to be honest with you, I don't think it's always the best sites that are getting ahead, in my experience. I don't know what your experience is with Panda, but I've seen some things that are scraper sites, like that one site we were talking about, higher in the search engines.
Yes, I mean, I found all sorts of things that I thought were not timely. They were old, and they were mostly garbage, and they outranked other things. So, no, I don't think that the update really made things better for people who are searching.
No, I think there's a lot of people that have, this is just my opinion, they're insecure and they're jealous of anybody who writes and tries to market themselves or has a website. That's the impression I get. Because there's a lot of hatred for people on Hubpages and Speedo. And if you go to Reddit, which is a website I decided I really do not like, they have entire forums just devoted to trashing anybody that writes their own website. And that's...
Yeah. Those Reddit people were really mean to me. I mean, I actually got a lot of traffic from them when I was new on Hubpages. But they went and read about Bo, and all they wanted to do was say hateful things, and some of it was really nasty.
They think the Google update is. I don't think it is. I think there's a lot of people that are just mass blocking websites that might have good content on them because they have a grudge against a certain website. That's the impression I'm getting from the Panda update.
Well, yeah, there's a little bit of that, and there are just the very well-established sites, you know. So right now, if you're looking to purchase something, you'll see the department stores earlier than maybe an article that actually describes the product. So there's a lot of that. I noticed that you also do a lot of drawing and artwork and crafts. Mm-hmm. How does that work in with your writing is it separate, or do you feel like it's the same kind of creativity?
It actually works in pretty well. To be honest with you, I've written a lot of crafting articles, a lot of art articles. I've been writing for The Examiner for 2 years. I write on a lot of different websites. I'm a national examiner. I used to write articles, like several articles per week for them. I stepped back a little bit from that when I started working on my own websites this year. But I was pretty active with them, and as a national examiner, people are always reading your articles, looking for crafting ideas. And I've had parents who came to me and said that articles I did on shirt painting inspired them to get their kids into trying a craft that they thought was too messy. And I explained it in a way that they never thought of how they could organize it. And so I've gotten some good feedback, not as much as the entertainment aid examiner, but as a national examiner, I have got some traffic for my art. And I'm also on a couple other websites where I share my art. So I think it works in well. Plus, I've just always had a lot of interest. I've always been into drawing, art, writing. I was a history major in college. I've done a lot of different things. So it's just who I am.
Yeah, I think it's wonderful to be able to do all of them together and, you know, integrate all those different interests. But sometimes before the web was such a big thing, we had to do all those things separately, and we had different groups of people that we shared different things with, but now we can share it all.
That's true. And then especially I think it's really neat with Bo, like seeing him. That's so neat. That's something I never would have seen if it weren't for the internet. So I discover a lot of new things. I also saw another website with elephants that were painting pictures. There's so many things that I would never have discovered without the internet. I think it's really cool.
Yeah. I think it's a whole new world. It really is. Is there anything else that I haven't asked you, but you really want to talk about?
While we're writing, I just wanted to say I really like your site, how it's small and how you encourage people to write what they're interested in. And I think that's a good thing. A lot of sites are getting to the point where they're so large that they're not encouraging creativity anymore or differing opinions. So I just wanted to say I really appreciate your website and how you allow people to do that. So thank you for letting us write on your website.
Well, thank you for writing there. It would be kind of empty without people writing. So it works out both ways. But yeah, when I joined Hubpages, I appreciated the fact that they allowed different people to express different opinions. And even though I don't like necessarily what's been going on there now, I want to follow in their footsteps, and I don't want everybody to have the same opinion on my site. I'd like to see different opinions expressed, different styles. I think it's more interesting that way.
Plus, I think in the long run, people will respect your site more. And I'm not trying to get down on Hubpages or other sites. I know a lot of them think that they're trying to help themselves in the search engines, but I just think they're discouraging a lot of writers and people are leaving.
Yeah. Unfortunately, that's been the trend. But anyway, we're lucky that we were there when it was still a lot of fun and we got to meet each other take all of that away. So, okay, well, I think we have plenty of material here for me to work this out into a very nice interview. And so why don't we sign off, and I'll let you know when I have it all worked out.
All right, thank you, and have a good night.
Okay, you too. Bye-bye.